In just 2 short years in office, Maine's governor has managed to compare the IRS to Hitler's murderous Gestapo. He told the NAACP to kiss his tush, shall I say. And now Paul LePage is dodging reports that he accused the president of, quote, hating white people, unquote. That accusation comes from the Portland Press Herald, citing two unnamed state lawmakers who were in the room, allegedly. Today, LePage denied the story.
No, I never said that, and you guys are all about gossip.
Let's bring in today's political panel, senior writer for the Washington Examiner, Philip Klein, CNN political contributor and Democratic strategist Hillary Rosen, and Washington bureau chief for Time magazine, Michael Shear. So, Philip, I don't know if he said this or not. He's denying it. There are two unnamed lawmakers. Obviously, I don't know who they are. But this does illustrate a problem I've heard some Republicans complain about, which is there are these attempts to reach out beyond the Republican base, and then people like Steve King or this governor tend to ruin it with headlines that the media just devours like sharks to shots.
Yeah, I mean, I think that it's clear that obviously this is based on anonymous reports and people who have gone on the record, including other people who were there, say that he didn't say it. So we don't know. But I think that the important thing is that any efforts that Republicans are going to make for outreach are going to have to come not from the top down, but from candidates. And I think that they're going to have to, you know, make their own outreach efforts and try to connect with minorities. And I think that one thing that's interesting that hasn't really been explored that much is that if you look at exit polls over the past few decades, while Democrats have always done a lot better among minorities, Obama exceeded the traditional Democratic model. And so I think one thing that's questionable is when Obama is no longer in the ballot, are Democrats still going to get in the high 90s in terms of the black vote?
Plus the turnout.
Plus the turnout. Or is it going to return to more, you know, typical Democratic models? Dominant, but quite as supersized as what we saw with Obama.
Michael, let's talk just a touch about Governor LePage, because the reason the story has gotten some legs is because it's not the first time he said something.
That's right.
Or he's accused of saying it, he denies it, but it wouldn't be the first time he said something fairly crazy. This is his explanation of the dangers of BPAs in plastic bottles.
The only thing that I've heard is if you take plastic bottle and put it in a microwave and it heat it up, it gives off a chemical that's similar to estrogen. And so, I mean, in the worst case is some women might have a little beard.
It's science. It's science, Michael.
Actually, my favorite LePage quote, which you haven't used and I won't repeat in detail, is he talks about one of his opponents not using Vaseline when he approaches the voters.
Right.
So, yeah, he's
approaches the voters for an unnatural act.
For an unnatural act.
Or natural.
Yeah. So he loves making headlines. And actually, you know, we know pretty well now that politicians who have sound bites like that can actually promote themselves pretty well because, you know, we all cover it. I mean, there have been a lot of people in Congress, you know, Michelle Bachmann, others who know how to deliver the
Is he a liability, though? I mean, this guy, he's starting to get a lot more attention.
I think he is. I mean, a few months ago, Jeb Bush went up there for a fundraiser, and Jeb Bush got a lot of flack. I mean, Jeb Bush, the guy who could be a 2016 candidate running from the center of the party, was raising money for Paul LePage, who, you know, talks Hitler when he talks Obama. And when you're comparing anybody who hasn't killed millions of people to Hitler, you're generally losing.
Right. But Hillary, of course, we're all complicated, complex individuals. The governor's spokesman is pointing to Devin Raymond. That's the young man from Jamaica whom LePage took into his home, whom he refers to, quote, as a son. They say that's evidence that he is not racist.
You know, we've just seen this time and time again from too many politicians when it comes to President Obama, that, you know, some, you know, racist things comes out and then they kind of deny it and try and change the subject. But and then Reince Priebus goes to the Republican convention and says, oh, we're actually going to make an extra special effort this year to reach out to blacks. I think that, you know, the problem that Republicans have, yes, they've got a couple of racist governors, but... Well, who knows? At least one.
You're just spotting them, a racist
and
governor.
I'm adding him another one, right.
Okay.
But we'll identify
named,
one.
To be named later. Right.
but really what they have is they just have a numbers problem, you know, that they're not going to continue to win presidential campaigns if they don't reach out more, if they don't have a broader constituency. But they almost talk about it in a kind of a a sort of political, inhuman way. And I think that that turns blacks and Hispanics off. They don't really talk about issues. They don't talk about wants and likes.
Of course, on the other hand, there are more Republican Latinos in the Senate than there are Democratic Latinos. People talk about Marco Rubio. They talk about Ted Cruz as potential presidential candidates.
And Republicans have done better. You know, George Bush got...
Tim Scott, the only African-American in the Senate, is
Republican. George Bush got 45% of Latino votes. You know, this year Mitt Romney got in the low 20s or something like that. So it can happen, and I think Phil's right that it's about the individual politician. But, you know, boy, this party stuff colors everything.
Philip, I want to give you the last word here. People say, conservatives complain, that the media only covers when Republicans say crazy things, when Republicans say racist things, and ignores when Democrats do the same thing. You agree with that?
I mean, I think there is a definite disproportionate amount of coverage in terms of focusing and trying to distort everything that Republicans say. And typically, also the way it happens is that if one Republican says something, typically what the media does is they approach every other Republican and say, do you condemn this remark? And it sort of blows up into a bigger story that then everyone has to comment on. And I think that that's what it is. It's part of the effort to try to any individual to, you know, like when Todd Akin made his ridiculous comments during the primary.
Senate candidate in Missouri.
Yeah, suddenly everyone had to come out and you know, comment on Todd Akin.
Believable. That's the problem. It's because the policies, it's not really necessarily about the personal slurs. It's because the policies that they're espousing connect with denigrating minorities. And I think that's why Republicans get it more.
We're out of time. I'm sorry to say, because that certainly deserves a rebuttal from Philip. But we'll